They're Algerian.
All right, quickly.
Yeah, exactly. It sort of reminded me when Pope Benedict made some critical comments of Turkey a number of years ago. Mm-hmm. They never talked about Muslim participants. They always talked about the Turks were unhappy. Yeah. Well, there are different groups in Turkey, as far as I remember. Right. I've seen the country.
We have very little limited time left, but I do want to bring up this story about Al Aram newspapers. It's very interesting. There was There was a meeting of world leaders. And if you take a look at the picture on the left, you'll see the picture as it was with in flight formation, a group of geese. You have President Obama in the lead. What they did with Al Aram newspapers, they photoshopped it to take Hosni Mubarak from the number 5 post and put him in the number 1. I'm glad they're not in charge of horse racing. and said that Mubarak up front. And when he was questioned about it, the president, the editor of Al Mubarak, of Al Aram, said the following. It could be called that.
He owns a paper?
He said that the expressionist photo that I've created is a brief, live, and true expression of the prominent stance of President Mubarak in the Palestinian issue, his unique role in leading it before Washington or any other. The photo is still posted on the newspaper's website in spite of being caught. Quick comments all around.
Anytime you have journalists that are modifying pictures, whether it's lightening skin of individuals on magazine covers or changing heads of people in pictures such as this, that's debasing journalism.
Okay, quickly.
Again, I hate to pick on the Arab world, but this does happen a lot in that part of the world where truth is whatever I say it is. And we saw a lot of that after the assassination of Benazir Bhutto in Pakistan. There was just no end of it.
Well, I was happy to see Obama in second place, which is always nice for me. This was still wrong, and I mean, you show it as is. You don't doctor photos.
Okay, thank you. After the break, it'll be time for The Floor Is Yours. Please stay tuned. We love to receive your emails, and we're delighted to respond to them, so please do send us some emails. Now it's time for The Floor Is Yours. Ron Sillag, you get to go first.
No rants or raves. I just came across a very, very special person who I interviewed the other day. His name is Father Patrick Desbois, D-E-S-B-O-I-S. Please check him out on the Internet. He is, as I say, a French Catholic priest whose calling is to find mass graves in Eastern Europe dating from the Holocaust. And he visits places in Ukraine, Belarus, Poland, and Russia. And he does nothing but locate what he calls massacre sites, each of which contain between something like 10 and 100 mass graves. He interviews witnesses. He documents. He's meticulous. He's fantastic in clearing up sort of one of the last great riddles of where, you know, upwards of 1 million Jews are buried in these places. He is coming to Toronto on October the 4th. I urge everyone, if they can, to go see him. If not, please check out his organization. It's definitely worthwhile.
You know the website by any chance?
I don't, but if you Google Patrick Desbois, you'll find it.
D-E-S-B-O-I-S. D-E-S-B-O-I-S. Okay, thank you. The floor is yours, Jeffrey.
Nice coincidence for me being invited to participate in a program on social media because I'm wrestling with a dilemma that's social media related. My cell phone contract is about to expire, and I'm wrestling with whether or not it's time for me to get a BlackBerry. I'm concerned about the risk of addiction. I'm concerned about the intrusion on privacy. I'm concerned, I'm seeing Matt across the table. I am concerned about being inordinately accessible, and I'm concerned about having the responsibility to address all of the contacts that I may well receive. I'm aware of the advantage of having the opportunity to be able to email back to my assistant if I'm out of the office and to be able to communicate with family in a fashion different than the rudimentary form I have to use on my cell phone. But there are concerns. And I guess it may be inevitable. I'm like King Canute trying to hold back the tide. It may have to happen. But I don't know that I'm going to make the leap. So I'm looking for the audience. It may be extreme for you to say, pray for me. I wouldn't ask for that. Hope for me, I would say, but at the very least, unless you're charged with a criminal offense, don't phone me, text me, email me, fax me, or Twitter me. Just hope for me.
Excellent. Thank you. Yeah, I had many of those same problems before. I still got them. floor is yours.
Well, after that, I guess I'll go juvenile. I'm going to talk actually about Katy Perry and Elmo. You may have actually heard they did a duet together.
Elmo wasn't dressed appropriately.
No, yeah, that's what I gathered. Well, neither was Katy Perry, apparently. So what basically happened was Katy Perry and Elmo, for the season 41 premiere, there were a number of videos that were released, and the duet between the two of them just actually occurred. Now, unfortunately, what happened was, within hours of it coming out, a lot of parents started to look at the video. They started to look at what Katy Perry was wearing, and they were thinking, you know what? That just may not be appropriate for children. So what they chose to do is Sesame Street basically came out with an incredible apology, one that you'll probably never see again in your life or something like that, and basically said that the video is now only available at www.katyperry.com, and that's it. Now, there's no question that she certainly was dressed differently than, shall we say, others usually do when they get involved in these sorts of things.
Mr. Hooper never dressed like that.
No, he never did that I can remember, nor did Willie, nor did anybody else for that matter. But unfortunately, I think in this case, even with Sesame Street, I really don't think, one, a lot of young children are really going to be paying that much attention to it, and two, if this was really such an issue, I think there were people who probably saw the video being made. Where were they in the first place? This should never have been released if there was that sort of a concern. Or does this mean that the Sesame Workshop has a, shall we say, very liberal taste to it?
The sexualization of our young people proceeds apace. That's really what's going on here, folks. That's the underlying, that's the under theme. A couple of things we didn't get to this week and things we're going to get to next week. One, we didn't get to the story about First Nations people in Alberta not being able to face a jury of their peers when tried in criminal courts because the database from which jurors is being selected is a database of people who own motor vehicles and live within 25 kilometers of downtown Edmonton. Hello, First Nations people. The chance of you being called is minimal. That's something that I would like to address at some point, and it's something the media will have to deal with in finding out how we improve the nature of courts. So you've got a quick thought about that?
One, we can compare the Ontario Jurors Act goes on the basis of the Assessment Act, which deals with the voters list.
Yeah.
And as well, there's a specific section that says for individuals on an Indian reserve, they're treated in the same, a native reserve, the same as a municipality. So there is an intent within the Ontario legislation to be more inclusive.
That's very good. That's very good to know about. And there were a couple of other things I wanted to mention, and that is there's this movie coming out about the founder of Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg, who made his billions. He's 26 years old, made billions of dollars on the from Facebook. I don't know how money. One Sunday we're going to have to look at how they make money on that site, because I never use any of the ads. I know they pop up and people are paying to be exposed to me. I've never clicked through any of them. How you get to be a billionaire from these sites, I'm not sure how that happens, because if I had a client and they were advertising, I'd say, we got to target really narrowly. And how much did you pay for that?
It's understood dollar value. That's how it basically works. It's basically worth what the market believes it's actually worth, so to speak.
Yeah.
I agree with you. The clicking the ads, they do it. Obviously, some people do it. They must, but or they wouldn't have
them. He's made a phenomenal contribution to the school board in Newark, New Jersey, and people say, in an effort to diffuse some negative publicity coming out of the movie, which says he, like Bill Gates, did not originate his own software.
Protect his image. That's all.
And the other thing I want to talk about, which we're going to talk about next time, is there's been there's been a bit of noise about a woman who's a journalist, reportedly a journalist, advisedly we'll use that, carefully we'll use that word, attempting to get into the locker room and getting into the locker room of the New York Jets football team, dressed in a rather, shall we say, provocative style, steamy style. And the question is, and some female journalists came to the defense for saying she can go there anytime she wants. And I'm going to raise the question next time of, like, can guy reporters go into women's athletic, you know, dressing rooms, etc. The whole thing will come up for discussion. It will not go away. So we'll see you right here next time on Behind the Story.